Welcome back. We are still discussing crime and police crackdown. Now, my last question before the audience. What are the benefits and consequences of police crackdown? That two-in-one question. The benefits and the consequences.
Thank you, Ma. Mm-hmm. Everything that has benefits must have consequences.
Of course.
We're talking about police crackdown. There are benefits mm-hmm. and there are consequences. I think one of the benefits of police crackdown is deterrence. What do I mean? Police presence, like I said earlier, would deter others from committing crime. Mm-hmm. Let's say, for instance, somebody is arrested in the course of committing crime. Mm-hmm. That is when police crash squad appear at the scene mm-hmm. and get the person arrested, mm-hmm. and the person is prosecuted, and this person is jailed. It will serve as a deterrence
to others.
To others who have the same mindset to go into criminal activities, to go into criminality and violence, because they have seen somebody, their friend or their brother, mm-hmm. who have been jailed because of his criminal activities. The person will now take a second look. Mm. If I follow this step, I'm going to end up like Mr. J. Mm.
So I won't do that.
So I won't do that.
You refrain from it. From such decisions.
Okay. So deterrence is the major benefits of police crackdown. And another one we can talk of, I said it earlier, the intelligence gathering. Mm. The intelligence gathering and community. Intelligence gathering goes together with the community partnership. Because now we have community policing. Mm. I remember there was a time I was working somewhere some years ago. We had that cordial relationship with the community. Mm-hmm. If a stranger enters into the community, the police will be alerted because of the relationship with the police. And the police will go on intel, on surveillance. Mm. Police will go until they get what they want, then operation will follow. And the people concerned will be arrested and prosecuted. Mm. So, improving a community relationship matters in this direction okay. as one of the benefits.
Yes.
So, like I said earlier, intelligence gathering is one of the benefits. Mm. And it goes together with community partnership. Mm. When you get the information, you get the people involved. Get the appropriate authority. Then they will go and collect that information. They will analyze information. They will process information. After processing information, they will disseminate information. Then at the end of it, the information will be utilized for the betterment of the society.
But there's an issue there, you know. This police and community relationship.
Yeah.
Sometimes some bad eggs in police officers will reveal the person that gives such information. And it's not good.
Yeah.
It's not good.
So, like I said earlier.
And it made people not to be coming out forward now to say, I don't want to say, they will say, I'm you. They will reveal, you know, that kind of a thing. So if there's any way to we can also deal with that, that would be fine in the police circle. Let them keep confidence, you know, put this confidential relation, not to expose it. If I come, there's a strange person in my area, and I quickly dial 911, for instance, and I say this, the person shouldn't hear about it. But perhaps the person has money more than myself, and so how much were you paid? I'll give you so and so. I want to know. And because of the corruption and bribe you mentioned before, they will just put me into trouble. What I meant good for everybody, isn't it? So what are you going to do to that?
Yeah, like I said earlier.
So they discourage people 12, from cooperating.
In every 12, there's always a Judah. And like I used to advise my friends and people that are close to me, if you have any intel for the police, go direct to the head of the department.
Mm.
And if you go to the DPO,
okay,
in confidence and tell him, because the person you are meeting on the way, you might not know his mindset.
Okay.
Okay, for instance, you are giving an information to somebody who is downtrodden, even though he's putting on uniform. Mm. And then he knows that the person you are giving information against might be of help to him. You discover that In a short while, the information will be leaked.
Yes.
So the appropriate place to channel your information or your intel, go to the head of department.
I think that's a good one.
Go to the head of department.
Well, would they be allowed access?
Definitely today in Lagos.
Will they be allowed access? Okay.
Yeah, today in Lagos, there's no division. There's no division. You get to the division, you see the DPO number.
All right.
You see DPO number written boldly.
Okay.
All the police stations in Lagos. Okay. Area command, you go there, you see their number written boldly. You are free to call. Say, sir, Mr. So and so, so are you the DPO? Say, please, I want to come and see you. Say, come.
Okay, that's fine.
You are free.
Probably you have heard. So let's work together to ensure that this crime is drastically reduced. In the main consequences now.
Okay. The consequences of police crackdown.
Yeah.
Police crackdown means a lot to many people. Like I said earlier, I'm still repeating it again. Mm. One of the consequences is there is going to be miscarriage of justice. That's one. Number two, you will discover that the police will do some illegal searching. There was an incident that happened some years ago, which I witnessed at K2. A young aspiring man, an Igbo chap, doing a legit business. An information from one of his relatives got to the police that this man is a drug dealer.
Maybe out of jealous and envy.
From his family.
Yes, that's what I say, out of jealous family. And envy. You can imagine.
From his family. And the police went, searched the house, nothing was found. He was arrested, brought to the station, but eventually he was not found culpable. Mm, okay. He was released. What am I trying to say?
But they can't search without search warrant.
Even there with search warrant. Okay, we signed search warrant. But like, you know, what happened there, the landlord, the community, everybody came out to fight this injustice.
Mm-hmm.
Say no.
That the guy is a good one. A good
this man.
Man
is a good man, doing legit business. Doing legit business. And eventually, he was taken to their office, somewhere in Lagos, not a Renketu there. Mm-hmm. And after much interrogation, he was released when nothing incriminating was found against him. Mm-hmm. He was released.
This also means that we also need to be very careful. That whatever we do, people are watching.
People are watching.
If you are doing bad, they are watching.
They are watching
you.
If
you are doing good, they are watching.
They are watching you. So whatever you are doing, be very careful.
Yeah. All right, thank you so much for the answers given. We go for a short break now to allow question and answer from the audience. Vivid View.
See and do it.
This is Vivi View.